We've just spent a lot of time learning how to do integrals. Now we're going to learn one of the important applications of integrals, which is solving differential equations. More specifically, we're going to learn about first-order ordinary differential equations. What that means is that we have two quantities, let's call them x and y, and the rate at which y is changing is something that depends on x and y. So somebody gives us a formula, let's call it f of xy, for the rate at which y is changing with respect to x. So once we get this formula for the rate of change, we have to go back and figure out what is y. So for example, let's suppose we want to understand how many people have the flu at any given time. Well, the rate at which the number of people have the flu is changing is the rate at which people get sick minus the rate at which people get not sick, either because they recover or, unfortunately, some of them die. So to set up the differential equation, we have to use some biology. We have to think about what determines how fast people get sick. Well, part of it is how many people are already sick, so that's a dependence on y, because the more sick people there are, the more there are people carrying germs. It also has to do with how many people are healthy and could get sick. It might depend on time. You know, in the winter, you're much more likely to catch the flu than in the summer. You know, certain viruses survive much better in cold temperatures than in hot temperatures. And finally, you look at the rate at which people are recovering. Well, that depends on how many people are sick. If you don't have anybody sick, nobody's going to recover. So you need to study the biological situation in order to write down a formula for this piece, a formula for this piece, and then you'll have your differential equation. Once you have the differential equation, then you use math to solve it. So math and biology work hand in hand. The biology to set up the equation, the math to solve it, and then the answer should be interesting to the biologists. Now, the very simplest kinds of ordinary differential equations, ODE stands for ordinary differential equation as opposed to a partial differential equation, is where the growth rate only depends on x and not on y. Now, the reason this is the simplest is because we've just told you what the derivative of y is. If you know what the derivative of y is, how do you figure out what y is? Well, you just integrate. And we've just spent a month learning lots and lots of ways to integrate. So, for example, if somebody says that the rate at which y is changing is 2x, well, then that means that dy is 2x dx. You integrate both sides. The integral of dy is y. The integral of 2x dx is x squared over x squared plus a constant. So there's not just one solution. X squared is a solution, but so is x squared plus 1. That's another solution. X squared plus 2 is another solution. X squared minus 1 is another solution. X squared minus 2 is another solution. You have a whole family of solutions that just differ by this constant. And how do you figure out a constant? Well, somebody needs to tell you an initial condition. If, for example, you started off at time 1, y was equal to 3, well, from that, you go back and say, well, let's see, when x equals 1, y equals 3, so my constant must be 2. And if the constant is 2, then you can figure out what y is at time 4. So we did a bunch of examples like this back when we were doing antiderivatives, and we learned about velocity and acceleration and so on. Now, the next simplest type of differential equation is where the derivative doesn't depend on x, but instead depends only on y. Usually in these situations, x is time. Now, the way to solve that is to turn it upside down. The chain rule says that dx dy is 1 over dy dx. So dx dy is 1 over f of y. Oh, now we think of it as x depending on y, and the rate at which it depends on y, the way at which it grows is only a function of y. So you multiply both sides bit by dy, and you integrate. So in this case, you get that x is the integral of 1 over f of y dy. and this will involve an arbitrary constant. And that won't involve shifting the curve up and down. That'll actually involve shifting the curve left and right. So for example, if you had dy dx was 3y, well, then dx dy is 1 over 3y, and x is the integral of 1 over 3y dy. Well, that's 1/3 the natural log of absolute value of y plus a constant. So natural log of y is 3x minus 3 times our constant. Exponentiate both sides. Absolute value of y is e to the minus 3c times e to the 3x. And y is plus or minus that. And we'll define a new arbitrary constant. We'll call it a. Plus or minus e to the minus 3c we'll call a. And we get that our solution is y equals an arbitrary constant times e to the 3x. So those are the simplest and second simplest kinds of differential equations. In the next video, we'll talk about separable equations.